my name is Heather Worship Coleman. This is Rolling with Jesus, episode 8, I believe. And you might notice that I'm without a tray or an iPad because I wanted to go old school and show you how animated I can get. Because today I'm just going to basically tell you a story from my India adventures. I was reminded of this particular story when I went to the Weary Kingdom concert. They had come to San Antonio to tour, and I was blessed to go with a whole bunch of my friends who love and support this podcast. Anyway, in the middle of the singing all the amazing songs, I was reminded of my time in India, specifically in 2006, the Office of Purpose in Asia was located next door to a bunch of neighborhood kids. Some of them had missing legs, and some of them had missing arms, and some of them were, as the world would call it, able-bodied. But these kids every day would come over and teach me how to play cricket, which is a very popular sport in India and other parts of the world. It's kind of like baseball meets soccer. And anyway, they taught me how to play cricket. And I was never very good at cricket, but they were always encouraging me to do better, much like God encourages us to do better for His kingdom. One of the things that I love about India is the people there make it a point to make you feel welcome, and they're very hospitable. They always encourage you and make you laugh. And I think that is something that the rest of the world needs to know almost 15 years later. Even though I wasn't very good at cricket or whatever activities that then little children tried to teach me, they always made me feel young and energetic and like I was capable of doing anything I set my mind to, which makes me think of the verse in Philippians, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. But the very first time I fell in love with India, it's because we were at I don't remember the specific event, but we were at a dance with all these people with serious challenges for dancing as if their life depended on it. With all the colorful outfits, they would sway and move carefree and easily. And I knew then I wanted to be a part of India and Provision Asia until the day I die. Provision Asia was the organization I worked with, and it helps people with various disabilities get jobs and learn English and learn a hobby, and it provides physical therapy and a bunch of other things that I'm probably forgetting, but the Indian people and the clients that Provision Asia worked with were so full of life and so full of energy. And in my whole 3 years of summers there, I never once saw anyone feel sorry for themselves or cry. They always had a positive attitude and a zest for life that I think that Christ would want us to have a life like that. Anyway, at this dance event, I saw a sunset, and it was the most beautiful thing I'd seen, even to date. India has a lot of people and a lot of animals and a lot of trash. But when you look at the people and you look at the sunset and flowers, you just know that it's one of the places God holds dear. And so I know you're probably thinking, why is she bringing up stories that happened 15, 20 years ago? And you're probably thinking, I wasn't, maybe some of you weren't even alive back then. But I'm bringing it up because in the middle of the concert, they were singing songs like, God's Love, and they were singing songs like Peace, and God is on the Throne, and all these songs that I heard the Kingdom concert reminded me of all these stories and all these people that I miss so much to date. And I wonder how their families have changed and gotten bigger. I wonder how much they have prospered in the Kingdom of God. And so, the thing is that I may never know how their life ended up on the earth, but someday in heaven we will be reunited, and I will get to know the end of their stories, and they will get to know the end of my story, and they will hopefully get to know my husband and my 5-year-old, who is very rambunctious and very energetic. But having said that, I know that when they get to meet them in heaven, or maybe someday in India, my daughter will not be 5. She'll be possibly grown and doing her own things for the kingdom of God. So even though my podcast is very short today, my challenge to you is, what are you doing for the kingdom of God today? And how do you want to spread the gospel? What is your India? My adventure in India taught me to live life spontaneously and vigorously, and have a zest for life and a zest for God's kingdom and God's people. So what is your India? What is your adventure? And what is God calling you to do today? Please leave comments, because I want to hear from as many of you as possible. Those of you who don't use YouTube, I'm gonna work on getting an email address, so those of you who only listen to the audio of this podcast can send me feedback of what you think and how you are being zealous for God, and what God is calling you to do. I want to hear from you, because all of your comments encourage me, and we can encourage each other. And that is all I have for today. May God bless you and keep you. May His face shine upon you. May you risk something big for something small. The world is too dangerous for anything but love. May God take your lips and speak through them. May God take your mind and think through them. And may God take your hearts and set them on fire. And next time I come, I will bring the actual copy of Dr. Sloan's benediction and read the words that I don't have memorized. But I hope that God gives you something that He sets your heart on fire for, and that you live zealous for. And all God's people said, Amen. Why should I worry? Why should I feel? Why should I?